gentleman from Minnesota, Mr. Emmer.
Tonight, we'll undoubtedly hear dizzying spin from Joe Biden as he attempts to tell the American people they're better off now than they were when he took office 2 years ago. But the fact remains, at the first chance they were given, American voters elected a Republican House majority to counteract Joe Biden's failed agenda. An agenda that has brought about 2 years of crisis after crisis, disaster after disaster. Tonight, Biden can try to gaslight on the economy and inflation. He can try to tell the American people they are not struggling financially. I'll remind the president that inflation surged to a 40-year high under his failing leadership, with economic experts blaming his policy. By the way, his own economic experts blaming his policies. I will also remind him that American families are struggling to pay their grocery bills, and they're maxing out their credit cards. This is not economic success. Biden can try to deflect on the border crisis his policies have caused. I will remind the president that since he took office, there have been nearly 5 million illegal crossings at our southern border, and fentanyl deaths are surging, facts which he conveniently ignored until it became evident there was a new House majority in town to hold his administration accountable. Biden can try to claim our nation is respected on the world stage. I will remind the president that this nation has not forgotten his botched Afghanistan withdrawal. And I'm sure I don't need to remind him that the entire nation watched just this week as he failed to stand up to our number one adversary, China, while they collected intelligence across the entire continental United States. These are just a few of the numerous failings of his administration. There are, unfortunately, far too many to count. No amount of spin this evening will change the reality so many Americans are facing. They are worse off now than they were 2 years ago. That is a fact. Luckily, Americans elected a Republican House majority to stop this madness. House Republicans are laser-focused on delivering results, as you've heard from these members today, and we're bringing Joe Biden and Senate Democrats, if they choose, along with us as we put an end to radical policies that govern, and as we govern for, as Chairman Smith said, as we govern for the American people. And with that, I turn it over to our